right, here we go. First question. Now, know that these speakers don't know what I'm going to ask them, so get ready. All right, so because all of you have made an impact worldwide by living out your purpose and passion, what would you say are some key steps for the audience to live out their purpose? And then we'll go in order. Jamie.
Back to what we talked about earlier, I think it's really planting seeds, you know, honing in on your gifts and what you're good at and practicing them.
I think for myself, it's always been trying to find that one thing that you're really passionate about, trying to do what you can to sort of make that happen and focusing your energies towards that, and embracing the struggle of sort of achieving that and sort of trying to live your life full of passion.
I guess just agree with both of you guys, right? Yeah, just the whole passionate thing, you know, just like stick with what you're passionate about, stick with what you love, and like I said with my whole topic, work hard for what you want because it's not easy, and then always stay humble, always spread positivity.
Everyone said it perfectly, but I think using negativity as a positive energy is something that people have a hard time converting to, and that's where, you know, you'll find success and strength in everything you've been looking at and looking for, and no matter how many times people put you down, just keep looking forward and use that as energy to move forward.
Cool. So in the pursuit of living out your purpose and passion, there will be naysayers, people trying to disagree with you or put you down. How do you overcome that? We'll go in reverse. Billy.
Sorry, could you repeat the question?
He's like, I got some time. Let me just chill. All
right. Yep.
Yeah. So naysayers, negative people out there, like, how do you deal with that?
You know, I think at the beginning, I feel like people who, you know, doubted me or looked down on me, it took a toll on myself. And until I figured out how to use it as positive energy, how to turn it around and use them as basically the fuel to your fire. And that's something it's really hard to overcome and do. But when you can achieve that is when you'll see a forward movement. And that's basically, you know, that's the goal, and being the end result is turning that around and using it in the right way.
I feel like the same thing. I used to do that a lot too. Like that used to be my go-to, was like kind of looking at the negative stuff to like be the fuel to my fire. And then I think it was like the reverse. Then it started taking a toll on me. I was like, dang, there's a lot of people saying stuff about me and I don't know if it's true or not. So then I just learned to just kind of ignore it. You know, you see something and you're just like, okay, well, they don't really know who I am. They don't really know what I'm about. And they're here online writing a comment. You don't know where they're at. They probably have like an egg as their like profile picture or something. And you're just like, okay, like, you know, I'm just going to continue to do me and just continue to do what I love. Just push through it.
In the beginning, it used to really bother me that I always really wanted everyone to like me. But when we started doing the festival, like, there's no way you can please everyone. I had like a group of senior citizens that like absolutely like hated me. There was like an anti-me group. It wasn't like anti like street art or anti-art or anti-pow. It was like anti like me specifically. And they would like try to find me so that they could just berate me, just so that to let them know that they don't like anything that I'm doing. And those kind of things used to bother me before. It didn't bother me as much like anymore, because then you just kind of get used to it too, at the same time. Like being hated is just part of it, you know? And so I've just learned to sort of like just let it fly over me. But there are also times when I'm like, you know what? I'm really gonna try to be this person's friend too. You know, like I find out that if I can find a way to sort of meet that person face to face and just talk, then it goes a long way as well. But, you know, as part of it, sort of like just ignoring it and just living and doing what you do because you believe in it and you're passionate about it. And also, at the same time, you know, for certain people, and also just trying to talk to people too.
For me, I found that that has been one of my biggest obstacles, insecurity. Because I came from, you know, I mean, everyone would look at me and think, oh, you're a model, and you know, you. But I was so insecure about my body. There was so many things that I was insecure about. And I realize now, looking back at myself, that it's all in your head, you know, and it's up to you to decide. Someone can say something to you, but you don't have to believe them. It's what's in here. So, you know, if you are passionate about something, it's something that you love to do, practice, practice, practice. And really believe in yourself, because anyone can tell you anything about yourself, but you know who you are and you know what's within you. So, you know, don't let negativity affect you. Don't let it get you down, because that's just somebody else's opinion. You know.
So I want to open it up to the floor right now. I have like a lot of questions, but I care about the audience, and I know some of you guys have some questions in your head. And then when I bring this up, they're like, oh no, I don't want to talk out loud. Like, use this opportunity to ask these questions, because it may not be specifically for you. It could be for somebody else who really needs it right now, and for the audience as a whole. So is there anybody that has a question?
Okay, my name is Exer, and I am a graduate of Brigham Young University, Hawaii. And I'm from the Philippines, straight. You can tell it in my accent. So my question is, what's like one of your biggest mistake in your life? Name one of your biggest mistake, and what have you learned from it?
Who do you want to start?
Oh, ladies first.
All right, Jamie. Or Jessica.
I mean, I already told you. I didn't sing for Prince. That was a big mistake. What I did to overcome it was, you know, it's still taken me time. And I realized that, you know, your voice, if you feel insecure, it won't come out. And I'm sure, Jessica, you can, I mean, everything that comes out of your voice. But for me, it's beautiful. But for me, I found that if I have any insecurity, it won't come out. It just, you know, I'll go flat, or, you know, I'll crack or something. And so, you know, I think that the biggest mistake I made was not believing in myself and not practicing and honing in on a gift that I did have, because I do have a good voice.
Damn.
All right, so duo with Titanium with Jessica?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, sure. We actually, remember when we did that show?
Yeah, that was a long time.
We did a charity event, and we did.
We did, okay.
I guess, I don't know, this is like the thing with like this question and like the whole like, oh, it's kind of like, what do you regret in life, you know? And what I've kind of learned, and I've always kind of, I've always like kind of stick to this, was I don't have any regrets in my life, because all the mistakes that I made was supposed to happen, who I am today. I had to go through those things to know what I know now. So I don't really have any like mistakes that I regret, or, you know, I've had a lot of mistakes that I've learned lessons from, but as far as like regrets, I don't have any. I feel like everybody should live life with no regrets. Whatever you went through, whatever struggles you went through, it happened for a reason, and you're in a better place now because now you know.
So. Jasper.
I think a lot of it too comes from like insecurities that I've had maybe when I was younger, just being afraid to talk to people or to try things because you're worried about what other people think of you. And that's always, I sometimes look back at that and be like, I should have done that, or I should have done this, or I shouldn't have been too afraid. And so it's really sort of a lot of that stuff in my past when I was younger. And I'm lucky enough to sort of get past a lot of that as I got older, or just from doing things. Like, I used to really have a big fear of public speaking, too. Like, I hated talking in front of people, and I would just forget everything that I was going to say. I did that at my brother's wedding, too. I was supposed to do a best man speech, and I kind of forgot the speech when I was, and that's like among friends and family, right? And so, you know, and then as I sort of, you know, whenever someone asks me, like, oh, do you want to do a talk, whether it be at a school or whether it be, you know, TFC or whatever, I always say, yeah, you know what, I'll do it, because it's like a fear of mine that I want to keep trying to overcome. And I kind of regret not starting that process, like, sooner in my life.
For me, I think, you know, I could say losses would be my biggest mistakes, but for me, I've tried to activate myself to where, you know, mistakes are learning experiences, and without making a mistake, you'll never learn in life. And I feel like there's nothing wrong with making mistakes. It's just part of your journey and part of your road to success. And I take every loss as a learning experience, no negativity and no mistake at all. It's just all part of the game and bettering yourself and sharpening your tools.